السلام علیکم ورحمۃ اللہ وبرکاتہ. اللہم علمنا بما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما تعلمونا وزدنا من فضلک علما انک علی کل شیء قدیر. او اللہ, ٹیچ اس دیٹ وچ ول بینیفٹ اس اینڈ بینیفٹ اس ود دیٹ یو ٹیچ اس آؤٹ آف یور گریس اینڈ یو ہیو دا پاور اوور ایوری تھنگ. آمین. لاسٹ ٹائم وی ڈیڈ لیسن نمبر 3 اباؤٹ دا پروناؤنز. Today we are going to do the lesson number 4, which is attached pronouns. In Arabic, attached pronouns are called as Al-Damair Al-Muttasilah. Al-Damair are the pronouns and Al-Muttasilah is the attached pronouns. As the name itself indicates, these pronouns will appear only attached to another word, which can be a noun, verb or a particle. So basically the word muttasil comes from the root word wa sad lam. Wasala. Without getting too much into the science of this verb conjugation or the surf, the base of this word is that this wow is dropped and a ta takes place here. And a ta takes place of it and it connects to the second ta. That's how it becomes muttasila. Muttasil, it means something that is connected. Hence, here the pronoun that has to be connected to a noun or verb in order to make sense. That's why the name muttasila. And the chart goes like this, again singular, dual and plural from right to left, and we start with the third person masculine, third person feminine. So this third person masculine singular is who, it's he or him or his, and the third person masculine dual is huma, there or them, and whom is the plural, there or them again, and third person feminine will be ha huma hunna. That's singular is she or her or it, dual is there or them, and the plural is same. And the second person masculine is ka kuma kum. Singular is ka, you or your, kuma is you too or your, and kum is you all or your. And second person feminine is ki kuma kunna. You or your, kuma is you too, it's same as the masculine. And kunna is the exclusively for feminine. And the first person masculine and feminine singular will be ya or ni. Ni is for the verbs and ya is for the nouns. The ya with a sukoon here. Write one more thing. One is the ya with a fatha and this one is ya with a sukoon too. Okay. So the above table should be memorized thoroughly. In the table, certain similarities to the detached pronouns can be seen. All the third person masculine and feminine pronouns begins with the letter ha. So hu, huma, hum, ha, huma, hunna. So all the third person masculine and feminine pronoun, they begin with ha. Hu, huma, hum, ha, huma, hunna. And the second point says all the dual pronouns ends with the letter mim alif, like huma, huma, and kuma, kuma. This is third person masculine and third person feminine, second person masculine and feminine. The next point says all the plural second and third person masculine pronouns ends with mim sukoon. So this is the third person masculine pronoun. They end with mim sukoon. Hum and kum. This is the third person masculine pronoun. Hum. And this is second person masculine plural pronoun. Kum. And all the plural second and third person feminine pronouns ends with noon shadda. The third person feminine is this. And the plural, it ends with hunna, with noon shadda, and second person feminine ends with kunna, noon shadda again. And the difference is in the second person masculine and feminine pronouns, which begins with the letter ka. There in the detached pronouns, it begins with alif noon ta, anta, antuma, antum, and anti, antuma, antunna. But here it begins with the letter kaf, like ka, kuma, kum, and ki, kuma, kunna, for second person, masculine and feminine. So those were the points you need to remember. Let's move to the lesson number 5. It says about attached pronouns with nouns. So these are the example with attached pronouns with nouns. We just read the table with hu, huma, hum, ha, huma, hunna, ka, kuma, kum, ki, kuma, kunna, ya, ni, or na, na, right? But now we are taking an example, kitabun. Kitabun is a book. So we are attaching kitabun with the pronoun, with the attached pronouns. So it is kitabun plus hu. So the tanween of kitabun, tanween bun is the dhamma tanween of ba is dropped and you have kitabuhu. So it becomes kitabuhu, kitabuhuma, kitabuhum, kitabuha, kitabuhuma, kitabuhunna. This is third person, masculine and feminine. Kitabuhu is his book, kitabuhuma is their book, kitabuhum is their book again for plural. And feminine is her book, their book and their book. For second person masculine, it is kitabuka, kitabukuma, kitabukum. For second person feminine, it's kitabuki, kitabukuma, kitabukunna. It's your book for singular, your book for the dual, and this kitabukum is for the plural. And kitabuki is for the feminine, second person feminine, your book. Kitabukuma is similar to the second person masculine. And kitabukunna is exclusively for the feminine. First person masculine and feminine would be kitabi or kitabiya. It will be like, because I told you that one is with the sukoon and one is with the fatha. So it will be kitabiya or kitabi. It's my book, singular, first person masculine and feminine. And kitabuna is our book, kitabun for our, like for two of them. And kitabuna is for all of us, it's our book. Above is the attached pronoun table with a noun. And note the following points. The first point says, the noun precedes the pronoun. The pronoun is translated first and then the noun. So here, as you see here, the first point precedes the pronoun. So kitabuhum, kitabu comes first, this is the noun, and then you get the pronoun hu. And but while translating, we translate the pronoun first, it is his, and then we translate the book. So first pronoun is translated, who is his. And then the noun kitabu, it's book, his book. But while writing, we write kitabu first and then the noun first and then the pronoun hu, kitabu hu. Similarly, it goes with kitabuhuma, kitabuhum, kitabuhuma. First, we translate their book. Kitabuhum, we translate their first and then the noun book. And same case goes with the kitabukuma. Kuma is first translated first. Kuma is your and kitabu is the book, your book. And same goes with kitabu kunna. You're translating your first, the pronoun, and then you're translating the noun. And the second point says that for the first person, the pronoun ya is used with a noun, with a fatha or with a sukoon here. So it's like kitabi or kitabiya. Sometimes you get sukoon for my book, kitabi, or with a fatha, kitabiya. The last letter of the noun when attached to the pronoun ya will be with a kasra instead of a dhamma. It will be kitabi. So you can see everything, all the attached pronouns with noun, It has kitabu in everything. It's kitabuhu, kitabuhuma, kitabuhum. So everything has a dhamma. The kitabu has a dhamma. Kitabukuma, kitabukum, kitabuki, kitabukuma, kitabukunna. But when it comes to the first person masculine or feminine singular, the dhamma of the ba, it drops and it becomes kasra. Why? Because it is joining with the letter ya. So here we have a kasra on ba here. Apart from this, rest all the kitabu has a dhamma. Kitabuhu, kitabuhuma, kitabuhum, kitabuna, kitabuna, everything has a dhamma. But only the first person masculine and feminine, this is attached to the pronoun ya, it will be kitabi or kitabiya. That is the difference. And the next point says, okay, now write the pronoun table for each of the following noun with the translation. For example, we'll take, these are the examples of nouns like qalamun is a pen, baytun is a house, rabbun is God, rasulun is a prophet, abdun is the slave, ismun is a name. So you can see any word that ends with a tanween is a noun. For now, you can remember this, and in the later lessons, you'll come to know like what is a noun and how the noun ends. For now, you can remember that anything that ends with a tanween is a noun. Remember, when attached to a pronoun, the tanween on the last letter of the noun will change into a single dhamma. This is the double dhamma, tanween. The double dhamma is called as tanween. And when it attached to the pronoun, then it drops and it becomes a single dhamma. So if it was abdun, when it joins with a pronoun ka, it becomes abduka. The tanween on the dal drops. It becomes abduka, not abdunka. And same goes with baytun. Baytun, when combines with hu, it becomes baytuhu. So taking all these points in mind, let's make a chart with rasulun, palamun, abdun and baytun. Let's take the example of kitabun with the pronoun. Kitabun is done. Let's take qalamun. Qalamun plus the pronoun hu becomes qalamuhu, qalamuhuma, qalamuhum. Qalamuha, qalamuhuma, qalamuhunna. Qalamuka, qalamukuma, qalamukum. Qalamuki, qalamukuma, qalamukunna. Sorry, qalam. Yes. And then qalami here. This is first person and masculine and feminine. What happens? The dhamma on the last letter drops and it becomes a kasra. It becomes not qalamuyi. It becomes qalami because it is attaching with the pronoun ya. It becomes qalami. Rest of them will remain qalamuna, qalamuna. And next example is baytun. Baytun plus hu becomes the tanween drops. It becomes baytuhu is his house. And baytuhuma is their house. And baytuhum is their house again. And baytuha is her house. And baytuhuma is their house. And baytuhunna is their house again. And baytuka, baytukuma, baytukum. It's your house singular, your house for plural, dual and plural. And baytuki, baytukuma, baytukunna. And the last first person will be baiti because the dhamma on the last letter of baitu, it drops and it becomes a kasra because it is attaching with the pronoun ya and it becomes baiti, baituna, baituna. And the next example is rabbun. It's rabbuhu, rabbuhuma, rabbuhum, rabbuha, rabbuhuma, rabbuhunna, her lord, their God and their God. Rabbuka, Rabbukuma, Rabbukum, your Lord, your Lord, your Lord. Rabbuki, Rabbukuma, Rabbukunna for the feminine. And Rabbi, here the Rabbu, the Dhamma drops and it becomes a Kasra because it again attached with the pronoun Ya and it becomes Rabbi, Rabbuna and Rabbuna. It's my Lord, our Lord and our Lord. And the next example is Rasulun. Rasulun plus who becomes Rasuluhu, Rasuluhuma, Rasuluhum. It's his Rasul, their Rasul, and their Rasul. Rasuluha, Rasuluhuma, Rasuluhunna. Her Rasul, their Rasul, and their Rasul. Rasuluka, Rasulukuma, Rasulukum. Your prophet, and your all prophet, prophets of your all. And Rasuluki, Rasulukuma, Rasulukunna. It's for, again, your Rasul and for the feminine. And Rasuli, now the Rasulu, the Dhamma on the Lu, Lam drops and it becomes a Kasra. And it becomes Rasuli or Rasuliya. It's my Rasul. And Rasuluna, the Dhamma remains here in all the other examples. Rasuluna and Rasuluna. It's our Rasul. And the next example is Abdun. Abdun will be Abdun plus who becomes Abduhu, Abduhuma, Abduhum. It's his slave, their slave, and their slave. Abduha, Abduhuma, Abduhunna. Your slave, their her slave for the feminine, their slave, and their slave. Abduka, Abdukuma, Abdukum. Your slave, and your slave. Abduki, Abdukuma, Abdukunna. And now, what happens here? Abdu, the Dhamma on the Dal drops and it becomes a Kasra. And it becomes Abdi or Abdiya, Abduna and Abduna. And the last example is Ismun. Ismun plus who becomes Ismuhu, Ismuhuma, Ismuhum. His name, and their name. Ismuha, Ismuhuma, Ismuhunna. Her name, their name. Ismuka, Ismukuma, Ismukum. Your name. Same goes with Ismuki, Ismukuma, Ismukunna. Your name for the feminine. And here what happens? Again the Dhamma drops for the ismu and it becomes ismi with the sukun or ismiya, ismuna and ismuna. Ismi is my name and our name for the plural. So these were the examples given here. And these are the examples of kitabuhu, kitabuhuma, kitabuhum, and rasuluhu, rasuluhuma, rasuluhum, and abduhu, abduhuma, abduhum. These are the rough notes which I had made during my when I used to attend the classes. Qalamun and rabbun and baitun. So these are the examples. You can go through them. And now let's try to find some examples from the Quran for the attached pronouns, that is damair muttasila. Let's go to Surah Baqarah. And the ayat, it says, وَإِذَا خَلَى بَعْدُوهُمْ إِلَى بَعْدٍ. So here, بَعْدُوهُمْ, this is, بَعْدَ is the noun, and هُمْ is our attached pronoun. So بَعْدُوهُمْ is attached to the بَعْدُ. So this is attached pronoun. بَعْدُوهُمْ, some of them. Okay. And Rabbikum. Here it's Rabbu. Rabbu is the God. Rabbikum. This you'll learn in the coming lessons about why there is a kasra on the Rabbi. For now, just you can remember it's the combination of Rabbu and the noun and the pronoun, your Lord. And this is our detached pronoun. Wahin wa in hum illa yadhunnun. Here, hum is the detached pronoun because it is not attached to anything. It's and not they do not do anything except guess. Then we can go to Surah Baqarah. Here we have ahduhu, ahdahu. It's his covenant. It's ahda is the noun and who is his. And while translating, you translate the pronoun first. It's his covenant. And خطيئته. It's his sins. خطيئة, it's a noun, sins, and who is his? His sins. And again, we have their detached pronoun here. Anna ashabu nari hum fiha khalidun. So hum is our detached pronoun in the previous lesson, which we learned about it. And this is qabla is the noun and ka is the pronoun. It's before you. And hum is our detached pronoun here. Wabil akhirati hum yuqinun. And rabbihim. This is rabbun plus hum. So the tanween drops. It becomes rabbi. It's their lord. Wa ulaika humul muflihun. Hum is our detached pronoun. And antum is our detached pronoun here. Andadan wa antum ta'lamun. While you, antum, it's not attached to anything. And again here, abdina, abd is the slave, and na is our pronoun. So you translate the pronoun first, our, and then the slave. Call shuhada'akum, your witnesses. Shuhada is a noun. And kum is our pronoun. It's your witnesses. Shuhada is the witness. And huwa is our detached pronoun. Huwa alladhi khalaqa lakum. He is the one. وَهُوَ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمٍ. Huwa again is your detached pronoun. So, Jazakallah khair for attending. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.